taken up, some of you may recall, at your last meeting, being in Perry, I was able to participate in a panel discussion. And one of the things I really wanted to highlight during that panel discussion was that it's really important for the task force to consider the importance of prescribed burn. And that's relevant to both publicly owned conservation lands, privately owned conservation lands, also to agriculture. You know, agriculture is another critically important industry within this study area. I have, since that last meeting, really been digging into the data available through the Forest Service, so I can be a little more specific and just say there's a whole lot of burning going on in this area. I can tell you that over the last 10-year period, 2010 through 2019, more than 18,500 burn authorizations were issued by the Forest Service within this M4 study area. A little addition, or excuse me, a little math, that comes out to a little over 5 burn authorizations a day, every day for the last 10 years. Those burn authorizations encompass the land area of just under 3 million acres. And the one statistic that really jumped out at me and actually shocked me. Of those 18,500 plus burn authorizations, more than 16,000 of them, 88% of them all, were issued to private landowners, the vast majority agricultural burns. So, the Native Plant Society is preparing a summary report on prescribed burning needs within this area. It's not quite ready yet, but well in advance of your next meeting, we will submit that to DOT and to the task force for your further consideration. For the benefit of DOT, we have the same exact data available in the other 10 course study areas. And we'll be providing reports, summary reports to do on those areas as well. I do have a few seconds left. I just wanted to follow up on some comments that were made about the ecological greenway corridor connections and the importance of east-west connectivity. I think it was Ms. Bowman from the Nature Conservancy highlighted the importance of those east-west corridors. I just have 3 words there, San Pedro Bay. If you look at the map in back that identifies the ecological greenway network, you'll see that there's one the most conspicuous on the map. It's one that's designated a critical linkage, one of the most important interstates, and it provides connectivity east-west to the Suwannee River corridor through San Pedro Bay, at least 2 approved Florida Framework Project areas within San Pedro Bay.
Thank you, Mr. Gale.